मॉर्निंग। हे यार, अरे देर
कन्वेंशन सर।
ओके ओके। तो एडिटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग मेनी टाइम्स वी डिस्कस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस पर्टिकुलर टेक्निक्स और मेथड्स इन द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट एरियाज और डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशंस। सी हियर स्पोर्ट्स इक्विपमेंट और ट्रैवलिंग आई मीन हेलमेट वी आर गोइंग टू मेक दिस पर्टिकुलर हेलमेट। सो हियर XR is the model of company. Company it is going to be made. See, 3D printed on demand. So these particular parts are made by using the natural fiber or natural materials. See, castor bean. Castor bean. Have you heard about this word? Castor bean. Hello.
No sir, unless
I think we heard in Telugu. Amalo gintu annara.
Yes sir. Oil type unda sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir, vennan sir.
These are the beans, sir. So these particular beans are make it into powder. So these are the renewable resources. Resources and using this powder they are going to produce these kind of products. Today a lot of research is going on to produce this sports equipment as well as defense equipment. Say this is the one of the company. They are going to made this particular XR helmets for the cyclists who are having the race, participating in the race. Especially they are looking about the safety purpose. See, let us go for the manufacturing of this particular manufacturing process. How they are going to manufacturing? Say, first they have prepared the 3D models using some modeling software. Whatever may be, yeah, I mean using CATIA or whatever may be. Unique graphics. I mean, nowadays you call it as NX extensions. See, no two heads are same. Definitely, geometric variations will be there. Yes or no? For a person to person, their features, human body features are differs. Yes or no? Hello. Response somehow. At least one or
two. Sir. Yes, sir.
So we need customized products for every human body. So here in this contrast to the limited number of sizes provided by the mainstream helmets brands. So nowadays we are having a lot of brand helmets, but they are limited to the limited geometry wise. They are going to limit it. So by this additive, I mean sometimes we feel that it is not flexible. So even though you have purchased a highly reputed company's products, also you are not going to satisfy with that. So here you are going to make a customized product. So here creation of your own personal helmet begins with the scan of your head. As I said, in the medical application, I mean scanning of your particular human body, it gives perfect alignment to your body or your head. Here the data is sent to the cloud servers. Definitely these particular inputs have been taken to the consideration, and they are going to they will give the geometric details for the particular head. See, hexa plant, I mean plant material. So they have taken these particular beans, castor beans. We manufacture our helmets from plant-based material, that is polyamide 11, made from 100% castor bean oil. So this particular thing, I mean, made by the castor bean oil. So the material is sourced sustainably. So every time and nowadays, even though we have manufactured with the high strength, we are manufacturing with the high safety. So a lot of research is going on towards the sustainability. So eco-friendly equipments, nowadays products related to eco-friendly products, they are going to, every engineer thinks about that, and it is must. It is also a must to think about that. See, which sustainable by Arkema through Pragati Innovative Initiative. Plant made from the materials from the plants. So it is a serious environmental hazard from the foam materials. So let us look after the about the this particular eco-friendly materials. That is, they are taking the seeds, many kinds of seeds are bed from the plants, and they are going to make a natural fiber composites. What is that? Natural fiber reinforced composites. Have we heard that word? Polymer based composites. Hello? Polymer based composites. Have you heard that? You can unmute any one of you. Polymer matrix composites. Hello? You can unmute yourself, any one of you. Okay. Let us have this particular session. So it's honor to involve the initiative to using the polyamide 11 to build the most of the sustainable bicycle helmet on the market. So this particular, this is 3D printing technique. It is one of the 3D printing technique. So the castor bean oil is converted into powder. So what I have said, it is first it is going to be converted into the powder and sent into our 3D printing factory. Each helmet is 3D printed. Offset of accommodate hair length and hard head. So this is the they are taking into the consideration human body. Even they are going to accommodate our hair. For free. The partners at 3T AM, UK. They are from one more company that is 3T AM from UK. Often produce formulae parts for Formula One and aerospace. So they take care of a tightly controlled step. So these are the approximately 36 hours for a batch of 6 helmets. So which means for helmet, for producing each helmet, they have taken the 6 hours. So having the personal touch, having cooled for 72 hours following 183 degrees Celsius, grilled at 3T AM. Each helmet undergoes a rigorous finishing process and ensure optimal quality. So if you see this particular design, optimum design, they are going for the optimization. So when you see regular helmets, that is having a solid structures. So here for the material optimization, they went for the material optimization. The first, all excess powder will be removed using a combination of brushing by hand and blasting in thin glass blends under high pressure. So definitely unfused material will be there, as we discussed in the 3D printing techniques, and some of the unfused material that to be removed using you have to follow some cleaning process. So that cleaning process, it is most of the times sometimes it may be made by manually, or it may be by automatic system. So the powder removed in this step is recycled, will be used to print further helmet. So this is the dyeing process. So I'm going to next stage, that is honeycomb structure is dyed black after finally being visually inspected to verify the structural integrity and finish quality. So obviously after removing the excess materials, so here this is going to be dyed black. So the color variations, whatever may be, and it has to be inspected to verify structural integrity. So every component, they are going to check the structural integrity. So if it is not satisfied, your component will not be successful in the market, or it will not be given. A customer will not be satisfied with your component. The dyeing process helps UV light attacking the material over time. So definitely ultraviolet rays, which is going to be focused on this particular product. So this particular dyeing process, which is going to be prevent that attacking. So that our helmets are. This is the company XR. So they are saying about their products. So that means more time checking the bike around, less time worrying about their whether the helmet is taken still up to the task. See the finishing touches. So after making the inner part of the helmet, they are going for the final ambience, that is we call it as outer part of the component. So the final finishing touch includes assembling the branded outer shell chin straps. So here some straps are required, you know already. So without hold on your head, so that the chin straps padding inside will be for the smooth when your body is in contact with the rough surface, you will not feel comfortable. So here that padding is padding and a voluntary ratchet system. So ratchet system is hook like that clips. So clipping part here, the ratchet system, we call it as, technically we call it as ratchet system. So not only is your XR helmet custom made to fit our head, but we also add your own engraving, helmet size and printing date to truly give a personal touch. So these are all about their manufacturing process, how they have manufactured. So what are the material they are going to use, and this is about the their manufacturing. So in some engineering things to be discussed for this product. So XR begin at University College London. So this particular directors who are maybe the leading company leads, they have started this particular designing or making this particular components at a London College, University College London. So founder Jamie Cook is the name. So we don't need all these things. So investigation to the materials and structures. This particular person has gone through the investigation to the new materials and structures. So definitely day by day, the material investigation is going to be improved, and a lot of advancement in the materials and manufacturing techniques. See, cellular structures have the highest crush strength. So this particular structures is going to have highest crush strength. Crushing, compressive loads, due to the compressive loads, the crushing will be happen. So this particular cellular structures will have the crushing strength to weight ratio. Strength to weight ratio. Always any technique, many a times I discussed this point. We are aiming to our objective. Our objective is to reduce the weight, improve the strength. Reducing by simultaneously we are going to reduce the weight as well as strength improvement. So in various aspects we are going to improve the strength of the component. So that is, so trying to make a bicycle helmet, we needs to both safe and lightweight. So the athletes, the international athletes, so rowing in the U23 World Champion. So this particular helmets are designed for the bike racers, those particular applications. So deep into the winter training camps. Many of the foreigners, they will go for the training, winter training camps. Here also the defense people is going for the camps, different camps. Or if you see NCC people also is going to for the different camps. Likewise, so here like our Indian people, most of the time they are not going to focus on education. So along with education, they are going to go for the their interested aspects, that is boat races. So here the defect, in our system, it is the major drawback. No one encourages the interest or hobbies of the particular student. So education system in new education policy, they have change all these things. They are going to give some separate certificate, and coming generation they are going to have more benefits. Skill certificate they are going to give while education is carried out. So skills also they are going to award marks in every stage. So that is different thing. So once go through the education policy, new education policy, you will understand what is the steps taken by the central government. So every design method for energy absorption assumes that the contact area is constant. So if the contact area is not constant, you may have some friction between the body and this particular product. So that gives it discomfort to your head. So but that not the case for a curved surface. We need to design for the head unique curvature. The only way to make curved honeycomb structure without destroying the mechanical properties of the 3D printing. So these are the different new structure it is made by this particular designers. but they must not disturb the mechanical properties. That means whatever may be the strength to be maintained, whatever may be the stiffness to be maintained, whatever may be the other properties that to be maintained, as well as they are going for the optimization, material optimization, shape optimization, everything. So 21st century manufacturing. So firm's pressure response is limited. So nowadays the firm's pressure firm's materials are limited. So there are only a few variables with play with. It's quite basic in the sense we are 60 years down the road of all these things. I mean, what are the disadvantages or limitations for the existing foam helmets? So, and even though they are only 30% efficient at absorbing energy. So energy absorption, in terms of energy absorption, they are only 30% efficient. So we have pretty pretty very much done. We can do with 3D printing. We have started. So on a new road, which has incredible opportunities for further optimization, design, and change. So this in this particular statement, what they are going to say is that for the foam kind of materials, it is definitely it is going to be reduced and the effectiveness also very less. And if you go for the new materials, definitely that is renewable energy raw materials. See, this is a castor bean, and this is the powder made by this particular bean. So XR inner shell is created from polyamide 11, the 100% renewable raw material produced by the castor oil. So this is the made from castor oil. We use sustainable paper supplies for our packaging, and no inventory is ever set on shelf gathering dust. So this is, they have taken, dust proof also they are going to take. So these are the different variants, the different variants they have produced. So regarding tests, never ending curiosity. So we have, so the hypothesized means a proposal. We have hypothesized for the argument, and being wrong, we have failed and failed again. So many a times. So after taking a particular research or a particular topic, you may not get results immediately. Definitely, our engineers will go through lot of iterations. Then they are going to have many failures. Only after that, at a one point of time, they may have the success. Even some particular project works will have failures. We never stop asking something could be better, to see how something will be can be improved. So that can be continuously they have worked on this particular product development. So because of that, we believe XR is the safest helmet ever tested, and we continue work. So the lighter and the faster still. So we have some limitations. What are the limitations here? Normal helmets or normal manufacturing process, it takes less time. Definitely, if the design is customized one, definitely it takes much time. What they are going to say, they will increase the safety measures, and they are going to reduce the weight of the component, and operation time they are going to reduce. So that is about this particular thing and the safety. 26% loss of brain injury. So compared with the foam helmets. So existing helmets are foam based helmets. So when compared with that, safety in terms of safety, they have tested and they have got the results. 26% lower risk of brain injury when they met in accidents. So oblique testing. So XR was compared independently to the larger available data of tested bicycle helmets. The testing method in the state of art simulating real time accidents at 22 kilometers per hour. So it is used MIPS to validate their helmets was developed by Professor Remy Ilinger. So he is the man who worked at this particular speed. So if you want to test this particular helmet, so then some speed virtually they are going to create in the software itself. How they are going to fail or deform. See how it is opening. All these things they have shown clearly through animation. So you are having a lot of opportunities regarding this additive manufacturing. So this particular team is going to reduce. This particular helmets, founder, co-founder, and all these members. So you are having a lot of opportunities in foreign countries also, if you learn these particular techniques. So some of the companies. See, these are the companies which are going in India, 3D printing companies. So they have given introduction and Indian 3D printing companies. So top eight companies are you able to screen. Hello. 22.
Miss, sir, screen can miss.
Okay. See, Brahma 3, it is the one of the 3D printing company. So they have introduced themselves. They are recently launched Brahma 3 Anvil, versatile, best for 3D printing. So this is the machine name. It has a high resolution up to 100 microns per layer. So minute thickness, which is having low thickness, that is a up to 100 microns and works on LCD as well as with the computer. So normal computer infrastructure is enough. That is, it supports a large variety of material including ABS. That ABS SLS technique, we are going to use this particular ABS polymer kind of materials made by the SLS technique. So PLA, polylactic acid, which is biodegradable. So they are going to use these particular materials, polylactic acid, which are biodegradable. So in case I forgot, PLA is popular bioplastic used in medical implants for the weight consideration. Weight consideration, even they are going to use bioplastic. bioplastic. So but definitely it has to be removed from your human body after some duration of time. So nowadays they are going to think about the biodegradable materials. So that is it must be completely degradable after some period of time. They are going to think, a lot of research is going in that area. So this particular machine or machinery can print objects the size limitation, that is 240 by 240 by 240. So equal heights and equal lengths are meant to be maintained. So they have given website for this particular website. So if you are really interested, you can go through this particular website. So next, the J Group Robotics. This is the other company. Second company. In the top 8, we are having the 3D printing companies. So if you are know this, if you are know this particular company names at least, if you work in this area, if you are able to produce a journal paper in this particular area, immediately you will get the opportunity. You can directly. So let me end the topic regarding